We do sometimes admire our prey, and secretly applaud when it cheats our snares.
I'm sorry, but I have nothing to say.
That is my problem. I literally have nothing to say to these people. All my stories about the amazing deeds of long-dead high elves. The first rule of my profession is to know your audience, and Grotwood is not a place to tell such tales. I plan to seek out wood elf stories in taverns and libraries, but since we arrived, I've heard of countless troubles in Grotwood. The worm cult, pirates, wood elf rebels. It's all the same. I'd rather keep to the safety of the carnival. The wood elves rarely write their stories down. But I heard Scholar Glorolan in the Elden Root Mages Guild is the one to ask. If you're headed that way, would you mind asking for a book? It could be written in Old Akaviri for all I care. Anything would help.
I hope you didn't travel from far away just to see Vendare the Magnificent. I am not performing at present. My magic cannot function safely in front of a crowd. The, stars are out of alignment. Oh, did she? Did she also tell you how she promised that would make 10 times our normal take by coming to this godforsaken backwater? Did she mention how she said shipping my supplies wouldn't be an issue? The shipping was fine. It's the delivery where it fell apart. My belongings arrived at the docks of Haven without incident. But due to the recent problems in the city, no one has any idea when deliveries will resume. As far as I'm aware, yes. They're in the nicest looking trunk on the dock. I had it touched up by a painter in Matisen, you know. But with the pirate attack, who knows when Haven will be stable enough to deliver their backlog of shipments? I couldn't ask you to lug that heavy monstrosity all the way here. It's triple reinforced steel with an inch thick lead interior. Discourages my competition from snooping. I just need the supplies inside, if you wouldn't mind, of course.
Look at them. Limbs so sluggish and carapaces dreadfully dull. When you've raised the shocks since they were pupae, it gnaws at your heart to see them so listless. They're having trouble managing the local grass. so I've put them on an all-hay diet. And the climate. It's more humid than they're used to in Somerset. If I didn't know any better, I'd say they were homesick. When they were younger, I'd grind mud crab eyes into paste and give it to them as a treat. I think it would raise their spirits again. But nobody sells mud crab eyes. And I can't leave my shocks to fade away while I scour the coasts. I would forever be in your debt, my friend. A dozen would be enough to go around if you wouldn't mind. And I won't mind if they're a little mashed when I get them. Saves me some work. Good luck finding the mud crab eyes. Only if you have the time. I realize it's not the most glamorous request. Would you look at that? Just the smell of the thing seems to have perked them up. I'll see if I can use them to motivate my little friends.
Do you have them? You have them, don't you? Oh, I shouldn't get my hopes up. They fell in the sea, didn't they? I knew it. I have the worst luck. Wonderful. That's everything I need. Once Haven gets its act together, they can deliver an empty trunk. You're welcome to stay for the show. Sit wherever you like. You won't regret it. Unless you hate stage performances. Then you'll regret it. But hopefully you'll enjoy it.